greeting.
How you doing, my friend?
Doing very well.
You pre-drinking yet?
I got a little Bailey's in my coffee, if I'm being honest. But I don't think that counts.
By the way, this is probably a very awkward way to start our segment with you, but what underwear do you wear?
Oh, how about zero?
Are you commando boy?
No, I'm not. I wear loose boxers, to be honest. I don't like the tight-fitting, restrictive, prison-like underwear I see many people wearing. I'm very loose, my friend. Kind of, I like a breeze. I like to move around. I like to be free.
See, I have a, this is way more than you ever want to know about me, but I have a testicular sagging issue.
So you need a house.
So I need some tightness. I need things to be pulled up or someone's going to lose an eye.
Well, I'm not there yet in my life, so thankfully I can still go with the loose fitters.
By the way, never Google sack jack. Okay, so...
I promise.
And it's not what he thinks it is. It's even worse if you look at Urban Dictionary.
Sack jack is a tightening of your testicles.
Not on Urban Dictionary.
From the sagginess of time. Okay, anyway, yeah, don't Google that.
By the way, Urban Dictionary ruins everything, doesn't it? It's just like, no matter what term is out there, they'll just be like, no, actually, that's not what you think it means.
How do you like the Edmonton Oilers' response to a poor outing on the weekend?
I loved it. Saturday's game was gross. Mm-hmm. We were all so fired up. We were all jacked up. It was the first game in months. Everybody was excited. Everybody was drinking all day. It was a beautiful day in the city. And then they came out so flat. It was so disappointing given how much hype and anticipation went into that game. So they had to rebound. And the fact that they were led by Connor, he looked like a man possessed. Like even his interviews between periods, he looked so angry. And yeah. I loved it.
We were talking about his mansion because a bunch of pictures just got released. His wife just released or did an article with a local mag, and there's some pictures and things like that. And I was saying to Grant that kind of surprised me that he seems like the type that wouldn't want that kind of stuff out there. Do you have concerns about his personality and how he comes off in the press and how that might reflect him as a leader in the dressing room? Because that's my concern. No? Okay.
No, I don't care at all. Because the big, like, Adrian Dater said that after game one. He's a journalist from Colorado. He called Connor McDavid's personality bland and that it rubs off on his teammates. No, I don't care at all that he gives bad answers in interviews. All I want him to do is win. Because I'll tell you what, when Sidney Crosby won Stanley Cups, nobody was talking about his boring personality. Yeah. When Jonathan Toews won Stanley Cups, nobody's talking about his boring personality.
And he's really boring. Like, everyone calls him Captain Serious. Yeah. His teammates call him that.
In fact, those two guys are praised for being so focused and goal-driven that, you know what, Connor just hasn't gotten there yet. And when he wins, people will be like, oh, Connor McDavid is so focused. Because, like, look at what he did on Monday night.
Yeah.
You don't think that fired up the boys, seeing how pumped he was after all three goals? Just his goal celebrations were fired up.
I loved how mad he was in between periods, too. Yeah. They tried to interview him.
Exactly. And he's driven. I have no concerns about Connor McDavid's personality. I think he is just fine.
All right.
And it was even interesting to see, like, he had some former teammates. Chris Weidman, people don't even remember that he was an Oiler. He was only here for 3.5 seconds before he got traded away. He came out and tweeted that Connor McDavid is exactly the kind of person you want to lead your hockey team. He's great in the room. He's great on the ice. He's the kind of person you want. So
that's what I'd rather hear that than some journalist. But I have had concerns about his lack of personality, I guess is the best way of describing it. But if the teammates are the one, they're the ones that need to respond when their leader is doing well or not doing well, right? And if he can motivate them, regardless if it's, you know, by something he says in the dressing room or his actions on the ice, then that's a leader, right? So good.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I think that I have no, of all the things to be concerned about with the Edmonton Oilers, he is not one.
I do have concerns about the Chicago Blackhawks team. I mean, I know everyone was talking about them being kind of sneaky good, and this is not a great first-round matchup for the Oilers, and I didn't disagree with any of that, but I still thought that the Oilers would prevail. But I'm still... I'm still stung from that loss on Saturday. That they looked bad, and I'm worried that Chicago could take the Oilers to the woodshed again.
Well, here's the thing. If you underestimate your opponent at any, like, if you're at the highest level, which the NHL is, and you underestimate your opponent, they're going to beat you.
Yeah.
The reality with Chicago is they still have guys, three specifically from their last Cup team, Kane, Taves, and Keith, that, you know, they've been there before. They know what it takes to win. Oh, and Crawford as well, I should say.
Yeah.
And they've got guys that have done it. They've got guys that can hurt you if you give them a chance. And that's what the Oilers did on Saturday. They made so many mistakes. They were sloppy. They made a habit of passing to no one in particular. But on Monday, they tightened a lot of that stuff up, and Chicago didn't look nearly as effective. Obviously, Patrick Kane's still dangerous when he gets a chance, so they're going to want to limit his opportunities. But I think that they really have to focus. And if they play like they did on Monday, then they're going to be fine. But if we get another game like we saw on Saturday,
yeah,
then yeah, they're going to be in trouble. They can't allow that to happen again.
Does Koskinen start tonight?
He has to. To me, like, the thing that frustrated me about Saturday's game was, okay, Mike Smith, the first goal, that was tough. That was on him. But I don't think the rest necessarily were 100% his fault. Where I had the problem was that I thought he should have gotten the hook earlier, as opposed to waiting until the game was already dead in water before making the change.
Yeah, and the fact that he came back in after the first two is ridiculous.
Well, yeah, and so that's where I thought there should have been a change. Maybe Tippett made a mistake on that, but I don't know. I thought Koskinen, he wasn't perfect on Monday, but he made enough saves to get the win. That's what matters, and I think they'll go to him in game two. But as we've seen so many times in Oilers fandom, what the hell do I know? You know?
Yeah, yeah. I play tunes for a living.
Well, that's just it, and I write dumb tweets for a living, so it's, we're one and the same.
All right, Baggedmilk. Thanks for your time today.
But since we started talking, the 50-50s...
Stop talking about it. I want to be able to buy tickets.
230,000 now.
Jesus!
Get your tickets, people!
You gotta get them now, because by 6 or 7 o'clock at night, you won't be able to get through on that site.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, Baggedmilk.
I'm on my way.
Have a good one. Take care, man.
Later, boys.
Baggedmilk, Oilers Nation.